Greetings to you all. I am Father Francis Mukasa of the Congregation of Holy Cross, and I work as a parish priest at Konge Lukuli Parish in Kampala Archdiocese. Today we are going to reflect or to share about the Advent wreath. We know that Advent is a time of hopeful expectation of the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, which takes a twofold. The first is Jesus' birth in body, and the second is his parousia, the second coming of Jesus Christ. But now let us look at the number of the candles, at the shape of the Advent wreath and their color, and the color of the candles. First of all, the Advent wreath is made in a circular shape. We know that a circle has no beginning and has no end. So this circular shape symbolizes the unending love that God has for us. As we all know, in John chapter 3, verse 16, that for God so loved the world that he gave it his only Son. Whoever believes in him will not die, but will have eternal life. And still, the circular shape of the Advent wreath symbolizes eternal life. And also when you look at it, it is made in green leaves, evergreen, which is also a symbol of eternal life that Jesus promised to us, all his believers. Now we look at the number of the candles. Traditionally, the Advent wreath would have four candles, of course, each with a meaning, as we shall see. Each of the candles symbolized 1,000 years, and the four candles would symbolize 4,000 years, which humanity had to wait for the birth of Jesus Christ. Then when we look at the colors of the candles, we know that the first two and the last, which is the fourth candle, are purple in color. Purple symbolizes prayer, symbolizes sacrifice and penance, as we know that Advent is considered as Little Lent, because in Lent we do penance, we pray more, and we sacrifice more. And then the last one, the last candle, is also purple in color. But the third candle is rose in color. Rose symbolizes joy, because it is lit in the third week, when we are left with only 1 week to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. So it sets us in the mood of joy that we are now nearing to celebrate Jesus' birth. The first candle is a candle of hope, and it's also called the prophet's candle. We know very well that the prophet John the Baptist is the one who proclaimed the coming of the Messiah, as he urged us to prepare the way for him. Sometimes in our lives, we lose hope. And as we know that hopelessness is death, and hope is life. So this candle kind of brings, the meaning of this candle brings hope in our lives. But also, whenever we're lighting the candles, there's a short rite that is taken, and we are going to look at the first candle, the candle of hope. And this is the prayer that is taken as we light the first candle. O God, by whose word all things are sanctified, pour your blessings upon this wreath and this candle of hope, and grant that we who use it may prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ, and we may receive from you abundant graces through Christ our Lord. Then after that prayer is taken, then the Advent wreath, since it's the first Sunday of Advent, is blessed with holy water, and then the candle, the first candle, is lit. After lighting the candle, now the last prayer is taken. Almighty and merciful God, open our hearts that we may welcome your Son, Jesus, worthily. Purify us to receive him with joy, that we may be filled with this wisdom and be together with him, with you, the Father, and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. So that is the rite that is taken as we lit the candle. This rite is taken every Sunday as we lit the candles. Thank you so much for listening to me. I would also want to encourage those who have been listening in your parishes. You may be priests. Please make very good Advent wreath. Why? Because they are aids of preparing the people for the coming of Jesus Christ. They must be beautiful. They must be attractive to help people to pray well in the Advent season. Thank you so much, and may God bless you.